Hey, how are you guys doing today? It's been a while since I've talked with y'all. Been missing you guys. I'm going to talk about two different religions today and how you can quickly share with them that the Word of God is connected to the religions and Jesus Christ is commanded to be obeyed in those religions. I'm going to talk about first Islam. Now, it's a tricky thing. People talk about Islam, you know, they get stoned, they get killed, they get murder threats. You can't make fun of Muhammad. And I'm not planning on making fun of Muhammad, but using his own words to talk about Jesus Christ. Okay, the Quran states it is a perfectly preserved tablet of heaven, quote unquote, in the Surah chapter 85, verse 21 and 22. Yet, you know, and you hear a lot of Muslims say Christianity's wrong and don't listen to the Christian religion, just follow Islam. But what does it say in Surah chapter 2, verse 62? Open up your crayons with me. if you have a crayon, if you have the crayon, their book, open it up with me. It says, those who believe in the crayon and those who follow the Jewish scriptures and the Christians and Sabaeans, anyone who believes in God and the last day and the work of righteousness shall have his reward with their Lord. On them shall be no fear, nor shall they grieve. It says basically, you don't have to be part of Islam to be saved. You need to just follow God. So we're going to talk about how you follow God. We're in a real contradiction here. It says in Surah, chapter 47, verse 4, and also chapter 2, verse 191. Yes, they have long verses. In chapter 4, verse 47 through 77, I'll just paraphrase all these things. It says, Allah commands Muhammad to compel men of Islam to go forth with the sword in jihad and kill people who do not follow Islam. It says, if anyone in Quran, in the book of Quran, anyone desires a religion other than Islam, submission to God, that's what Islam means, he will be in the ranks of those who have lost all spiritual good. And it says that in Surah chapter 3, verse 85. So one place it says, if you're Christian, you're following God, good. If you're not part of Islam, it says you're bad and you will be in the ranks of those who are doomed. And it says, do jihad on those people. That means kill them. And again, it talks about this. In the Quran, in chapter 9, verse 3, it says, an announcement from Allah and his messenger to the people assembled on the day of the great pilgrimage, that Allah and his messenger dissolve the treaty with the pagans, and if they repent, it were best for you. But if you turn away, know that ye cannot frustrate Allah. And you proclaim a grievous penalty on those who reject faith. This was originally written in the Quran. So basically, in this part, besides saying Christianity is good and then kill the Christians, he's saying do not be a pagan. That means worship any god other than Allah. And may his name be praised. Allah is just the Old Testament name for God, the Father. But we're going to see that there's a different thing here. Muhammad says, don't worship idols. Don't be a pagan, or you have a grievous penalty placed upon you. You will frustrate Allah. And when you reject the faith by doing paganism, Allah resolves the penalty, dissolves the treaty with you. You have no more connection with him. Yet, in the verses following, and this is very controversial in Islam, people get killed for talking about this in Islam. But it is in Islam, in the book of the Quran. And Muhammad endorses paganism, in reverent awe, no less, in the Quran. If you would turn with me in your Quran books to Nehemiah chapter 53, verse 19 and 22. Again, Nehemiah chapter 53, verse 19 through 22. Okay. It says, near it in the garden of the abode, behold the Lata tree. It was surrounded in unspeakable mystery. His sight never swerved, nor did it go wrong, for truly did he see the sights of the Lord, the greatest. Muhammad speaking in awe here. Have you seen Lata, which is a goddess, during the time Muhammad was writing this? And it was massively worshipped by the pagans before Muhammad and Islam became very popular through mass killing and causing people to submit to this religion. I've seen Lata and Uzza and the third goddess, Mahat. These were the three goddesses that were worshipped during the time of Muhammad. And he's writing it during this time period. These are the exalted cranes, the intermediaries. That means people that are the beings. Like Jesus is the intermediary between us and the Father. When we pray to God the Father, he takes intercession with the Father on our behalf. And Muhammad is calling these people intermediaries. And then he speaks further, whose intercession is hoped for. So he's saying, when you speak to Allah, they're going to intercede for you. These pagan goddesses. Now they delete. These words are hoped for. These exalted cranes, later on in the book of Muhammad, in the Quran. But the rest of this text is still in there. And it still lauds these deities. What for the male sex and for him, the female, behold, such would be indeed a division most unfair. Talking about how wonderful these goddesses are and how the female sex and the male sex, and just comparing it with these divine feminine deities. Muhammad uses female angels in connection to talking about the goddesses as well. He's a big fan. Muhammad, though, you know, like Joseph Smith and others before him and after him, retracted what he said. And the Pope, he does this too. Muhammad later says in his oracles that these were false, not from the right source. It kind of ruins all of his credibility, though, doesn't it? But Allah abolished that which Satan proposeth. It's in the Quran, chapter 22, verse 52 and 53. So if you'd like to turn there, turn the pages, we'll get to there. You ready? This is him backtracking. But Allah abolisheth that which Satan proposes. Then Allah established his revelations. Allah is nor wise that he may make known which the devil proposed, a temptation for which in those hearts is a disease, in which hearts are hardened. Lo, the evildoers are in open schism. So basically he's saying, Satan proposed this. Allah now has abolished it. He's now established his true revelation because he's all-knowing and all-wise, and the Father is. That he may make the devil propose his temptation, and those of the hearts is a disease. Basically saying that it's evil, it's abolished, Allah has fixed it. You talk with people in Islam, and they will say, Jesus Christ was a holy man, and he was a prophet. But we shouldn't listen to any words he says or does, because his words are false, because they've been corrupted. We're going to talk about this. What the Quran says that absolutely contradicts these arguments. Right here in the Quran, chapter 5, verse 72, it says that Jesus himself is the Messiah and a prophet and tells us to obey him. That means we can obey him. That means his words are able to be obeyed and understood. That means we can understand what he has said in the Bible. So why not follow him? In the Quran, chapter 5, verse 72, when the angel said to Mary, Allah gives us good news of a word from him, whose name is the Messiah, Jesus, son of Mary. It's the word of God. Word of God is something we need to listen to. Capital W. In the New Testament, John chapter 1, the word of God is called the Son of God, who is the illustrious one in the world, calling Jesus the illustrious one, and in the hereafter. And who is the one of those who is not brought near Allah. No other prophet, including Allah, has ever not been mentioned as confessing their sins except Jesus Christ. That's interesting, isn't it? In the book of the Quran and in other Islamic texts. Obviously, Allah has a reason behind that, you would think. And then he further talks about this in Sahih al-Bukhari, and the text here that he's written. If anyone testifies that none has the right to be worshipped but God alone, who has no partners, and that Muhammad is his servant and his messenger, and that Jesus Christ is his servant and his messenger, and his word, which he bestowed on Mary, and by a spirit from him, capital S, spirit. So Jesus Christ has the spirit of God. He is the word of God. He is bestowed through God, came through the spirit. And they believe Mary came by a virgin birth, as we do. And that this word, which was bestowed on Mary by the spirit of him, and that is a paradise is true and hell is true. The spirit is talking about that hell is coming and heaven is coming. These things are true. God will admit him into paradise with the deeds which he has done, if those deeds were few. If the deeds are few, if you accept Jesus, accept the spirit that is upon him and his word, God will admit him into paradise. Now this is the crux. Besides them, the book of the Quran and other religious Quran texts connected to Muhammad, saying we need to follow, listen to the word of Jesus, the Messiah. It says here in Yusuf Allah, in chapter 43, verse 63, when Jesus came with clear signs, he had the signs of the Spirit, he said, now I have come to you with wisdom, the wisdom of God, Allah, in order to make clear to you, to some of you, on which we dispute. He's going to give them facts, make clear to them through understanding the things that have been disputed. Therefore, fear Allah. Jesus is talking to this in Yusuf Allah, given from Muhammad. He says, therefore fear Allah and obey me. So when people say Jesus is a good man and a prophet, but we don't need to obey him, the book of Quran and other Islamic texts say we are supposed to obey him. It's commanded, obey me. These are the quote of Jesus. And Jesus called the word of Allah. And we need to listen to what Allah says, right? Allah would not give us something that could not be understood or obeyed. And we're going to mention that not only does the texts of Islam say that his word, Allah's word, is perfect, but also that the biblical texts are perfect. And that thus, not only should we follow Jesus because it is commanded in the book of Islam and the religious texts, but also because the Islamic text commands us to obey the Bible. The Bible is commanded for us to follow, to be followed by Allah, and to be obeyed. In Surah chapter 5, verse 63, Al-Mahdiyah says, people of the book, Christians and Jews, You stand for nothing until you observe the Torah and the Gospel, that which is revealed to you from your Lord. So basically saying, this has been revealed to you from Allah. Stand for it, you Christians. Follow the book of the Torah. It's commanded to follow the book of the Torah. Or you stand for nothing. And the Gospel. It says, observe the Torah and the Gospel, which is revealed to you from your Lord. So the people of Islam say, kill the infidel. And here it says, Christians in the book of one of the Islamic texts, obey the Gospel. From one of the texts from Muhammad. Also, it further talks about this in Surah chapter 4, verse 136. Al-Nisa, O believers, have faith in Allah and His Apostle. Talking about all believers here. Have faith in Allah and His Apostle, in the book He has revealed to His Apostle, which is Allah, Muhammad, and in the book He firmly revealed. What do you think that book is? The Bible. He that denies Allah, His angels, His scriptures, the book that is revealed, the book that was formally revealed, says he who has denied these things, and His apostles, Peter, James, John, Allah, and the last day has strayed from the truth. So yes, if you say you're Islam, you say you're of Allah, you got to obey the text. It says, of the book that was formally revealed, which it says the Lord has revealed, the Gospel and the Torah. Let's talk a little more on this. Last verse. Last two verses. Three verses. In Psalm chapter 5, verse 43, it says the Quran confirms the truthfulness of the law of Moses, the Old Testament, which the Prophet Muhammad spoke of. He met with some Jews in Arabia, and Allah said to him in this text, but why do they come to you for judgment when they already have the Torah, which is Allah's own judgment? So when people say, the Jews don't need to follow the Bible, Old Testament, because it's corrupted. Allah says they have the Torah and it's for them that I'm guiding them. He says, why are they coming to you, Allah? I mean, Muhammad. Allah says, because they got my words already. In Surah chapter 5, verse 47 says, the Quran says, let the followers of the Gospel judge in accordance with what Allah has revealed therein. Allah has revealed the Gospel. And it's commanded that Christians follow the Gospel. That the followers of the Gospel, it says, judge according to what Allah has revealed within it. Evildoers are those who do not base their judgment on Allah's revelations. Calling the Gospel Allah's revelations. And if Allah is perfect and all supreme and powerful, His words are perfect. Are they not? Another verse. Surah chapter 6, verse 115. Whether Bible or Quran, if given by God, they are perfect. Let that sink in for a moment. You talk with Islamists, the Arabs, Pakistanians, people who follow Muhammad, the Prophet, and Allah, blessed be His name, and they say the Bible is imperfect, you're not supposed to follow it. And what did we just read? Allah commands it to be obeyed. Jesus Christ is commanding people to follow Him. And Allah Himself says He has given it and it is perfect. So anything that's in the Bible, that should be followed. And if it says in the Bible and in the Quran that Jesus is the Messiah, He is the Word of God, and to follow Him, Yosef Allah, chapter 43, verse 63, that's what we need to do. And I say this with all respect for people. It's something that the Quran has said for us to follow. It says, the words of Allah are perfect, full of truth and justice. None of them can change. He is the hearing and the knowing. That's beautiful. We see some things here that say God's or Allah's words are perfect. And Allah, it says in the Quran text, has given us the Gospels and the Torah, has given us the Word, given us the Bible. So let us do what the Quran has said, follow Christ, follow the Word of God. Blessed be Allah, and blessed be Christ. Thank you for listening. God bless. Goodbye.